16,000 has jammed inside the Birmingham Jefferson Civic Center in downtown Birmingham, Alabama, for this NCAA championship encounter between the Auburn Tigers and the Tar Heels of North Carolina. Good evening, everybody. I'm Vern Lundquist, and welcome to Birmingham. The Auburn Tigers, of course, have been one of the surprise stories of this 85 championship. Tonight, they hope to continue what has thus far been a very impressive performance by members of the Southeastern Conference. The North Carolina Tar Heels would hope to continue what is traditionally an impressive series of performances of Atlantic Coast Conference teams. Our expert analyst here tonight is former Kentucky star Larry Conley. Larry, one is tempted, I think, to link the success of Auburn in postseason play with the resignation of Sonny Smith. Do you think that's the case?
Well, I think this team obviously would love to win this basketball game for Sonny Smith, but I think it really overshadows a lot of what has happened and the success this club has had. They've won 7 straight games. They've won a Southeastern Conference championship, and they've done it with 7 guys, 5 of them freshmen and sophomores.
One hears over and over again that this is not one of Dean Smith's better North Carolina teams. Here they are again with a 26-8 record. Do you think they're that bad of a ball club?
I think they're a highly talented basketball team. This year was to be the year of rebuilding for Dean Smith. He lost Matt Doherty, Michael Jordan, Sam Perkins, but he's been molding teams for 24 years at Chapel Hill, and when it's all said and done, he can put this one up there with all the rest of them.
North Carolina will have the tournament experience going in tonight, but this is, in effect, a hometown Auburn crowd. Back with the lineups in just a minute. North Carolina Tar Heels are meeting for the first time tonight in 53 years. Let's meet the players who will participate. Here's our public address announcer, Gary Sanders.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Good evening, and on behalf of the UAB Athletic Department, welcome to the Birmingham Jefferson Civic Center for tonight's Southeast Regional semifinal game between the Auburn University Tigers and the Tar Heels of the University of North Carolina. Now, let's meet the starting lineups. For Auburn, at forward, a 6'7 freshman from Atlanta, Georgia, number 34, Chris Morris. For North Carolina, at forward, a 6'10 sophomore from Kohler, Wisconsin, number 24, Joe Wolf. For Auburn, at forward, a 6'8 junior from Brantley, Alabama, number 45, Chuck Person. For North Carolina, at forward, a 6'10 sophomore from Ashley, Pennsylvania, number 35, Dave Hobson. For Auburn, at center, a 6'7 freshman from Birmingham, Alabama, number 40, Jeff Moore. For North Carolina, at center, a 6'11 junior from Black Mountain, North Carolina, number 42, Brad Doherty. For Auburn, at guard, a 6'4 sophomore from Kissimmee, Florida, number 15, Frank Ford. For North Carolina, at guard, a 6'5 senior from Asheville, North Carolina, number 22, Buzz Peterson. For Auburn, at guard, a 6'1 sophomore from Augusta, Georgia, number 12, Gerald White. For North Carolina at guard, a 6'3 sophomore from the Queens, New York, number 30, Kenny Smith. And introducing the head coaches for Auburn in his 9th season, Coach Sonny Smith. For North Carolina in his 24th season, Coach Dean Smith.
For the three who will keep things in order this evening. Well, you've met the players, and we're just about set to tip off as North Carolina takes on Auburn. North Carolina Tar Heels enter tonight's game with 26 wins and only 8 defeats, a three-way tie for the ACC championship. The Auburn Tigers are 22-11. They have won their last 7 in succession. And, of course, they defeated 4 teams to win the SEC tournament and knocked off Purdue and Kansas in the first and second round of the championship. J.C. Weinbach will throw it up before a sellout crowd in Birmingham, and we are underway. Auburn's Frank Ford will control and gives it off immediately to number 12, Gerald White.
Vern, I think the problem they've got to contend with, the War Eagle or the Tigers, as they can be called either way, really going to have to go up a tall North Carolina club.
There's the first foul of the game. It'll be called on Dave Thompson, number 35. Chris Morris, one of two freshman starters for Auburn, is at the line to shoot two. This has been, Larry, a problem for Auburn all year. They are not a good free throw shooting team.
Well, they've been shooting 64% from the line for the year, as you see Dean Smith right there. How about that for a career record? 550 wins in 24 years. Just an outstanding basketball coach. Great teacher.
Morris gets one of two, and Auburn takes an early lead.
Auburn immediately into a full-court press, 2-2-1 zone. Cliff Kenny Smith operate. He did nothing but knife right through that Auburn defense.
Quick skip pass to Buzz Peterson, and now Kenny Smith, the sophomore, who has 224 assists this year. That breaks a record set by Phil Ford of 217 in 1977. Back to Smith, fakes. Buzz Peterson with a nice fake. Looks underneath. Auburn in the 2-3 zone.
Smith told us he was going to get into his own defense and really try to pack it back inside. He was very fearful of the lob, really concerned about it.
Back to Kenny Smith, who will take the jumper and won't go. Rebound. North Carolina. And Thompson puts the second shot through.
And there's that size he was so fearful of. It went right back. They missed the first one. Thompson went back and got it again.
The Carolina front line tonight is 6'11", 6'10", 6'10". The Auburn front line is 6'8", 6'7", 6'7". Person, not there. Good job of boxing out by Thompson, but it's off Joe Wolf, and Auburn, this has been a good arena for the Auburn Tigers. They're 5-0 here this year. They, back in November, knocked off a very talented Gene Bartow UAB team by 2 points here, and then won four in a row to win the SEC championship here just 2 weeks ago. Gerald White. Shots he'll take today. He's cut back on the shooting considerably since midseason.
Well, North Carolina does a great job of blocking off the board. There were no blue shirts near that basketball when it came off.
Kenny
and again,
Smith,
excuse me, as I was going to say, back to that zone defense again.
Daugherty. Quick 4-1. North Carolina lead.
Now North Carolina comes out in the man-to-man defense, and Auburn immediately tries to look inside the first one.
Shot goes for freshman Jeff Moore, number 40. It's 4-3, 17-43 to go in the first half.
You watch that zone defense that Auburn employs. They really move Frank Ford up and down in that lane. So when the ball goes to the baseline, he'll go down inside and try to protect or help the other guys inside. You got so many big problems inside. North Carolina being very patient on offense right now. They're taking a look at the zone defense, kind of feeling it out.
Kenny Smith will pass on the shot quickly over to Buzz Peterson, who's starting for Steve Hale. Tipped away. Chris Morris. Here comes Auburn with a chance for the lead. Person off the glass. Not there. Rebound Daugherty. North Carolina's got it. Coming the other way on the run. Kenny Smith. He's quick as a cat.
Oh, what a move. Chris Morris with a foul.
When they refer to the North Carolina team as slow-footed, he's not the guy they've got in mind.
No, not at all. Watch him go up and stuff him up. I think he surprised Morris. I think he got up there so high, Morris was expecting to block that shot, and he lagged behind Smith expecting to reject it, and Smith got up so high on him, it really surprised him.
That's a four-point North Carolina lead, and it comes with 16:58 to go in the first half of play. Gerald White, who Sonny Smith told us this afternoon, really is not a true point guard, but they're trying to make him into one.
North Carolina does a great job of trapping out of that zone defense. They'll bring a guy up on the wing and try to press the one guy who handles the basketball, and if they don't get the turnover or the steal, then they go immediately back into that zone defense.
Now look at Auburn come back and try and reassess what difficulties confront them.
Now North Carolina changed defenses again. Now they're in a man-to-man. It's a very intelligent club.
White, not there. That's a second wild shot he's taken. There's a third that will not go, and Brad Daugherty is fouled. Oh, no, traveling.
Dean Smith really upset. That was Sonny Smith on the other end. You got to keep qualifying this. We're going to say Sonny Smith, Dean Smith.
Well, they are not brothers. Might go to Dean and Sonny before it's at all over.
16-11 to go, 7-3. North Carolina leads. Gerald White, number 12, from Augusta, Georgia. Chris Morris. And Joe Wolf for the rebound at 6-10. Auburn has out-rebounded clubs they played this year by more than 8 per game. That's not been the case early on. Shoving off, Chuck Burson.
He didn't have any argument at all. He immediately rose his hand, raised his hand and said, I was the one that committed the foul. He did push off on the inside. North Carolina will...
Inbounds play. No basket.
There's Warren Martin right there. Really gives North Carolina a big lift coming off of that bench. At his size, he's 6'11 and a half coming off of there. Gerald White, who's only 6'2, trying to go up and try to take it away from him. I tell you, Warren Martin is 6'11 and a half. About 6 feet of it is legs.
He's not the most picturesque ball player you will see.
I tell you, he's come a long way, though. I remember seeing him as a freshman, and he really has made great progress, and you've got to give Dean Smith and his staff credit for that.
Martin draws the foul. It's not only Dean Smith, though, Larry, in the case of Warren Martin. There's the foul as you watch it on the replay. He's also taken up swimming and running, trying to improve his coordination. Watch it now.
Here's a good move. Kenny Smith with a great pass to the inside. Warren Martin with a good turnaround, tried to get it to go through and got fouled. I'll tell you the thing about North Carolina, too, is they look to the inside with this big, tall, thundering club that they've got. You really want to go to the strength of your offense, and their strength is really their size. And it's a little different than most North Carolina clubs he's had in the past. He's always relied a lot on quickness, but he hasn't been able to do that this year.
That rebound goes Auburn's way. A 5-point North Carolina lead, 15-40 to go, first half. And what is a predominant Auburn crowd has been stilled a little bit. Morris, shots on falling for the Tigers. Rebound Kenny Smith. Martin in the corner, Joe Wolf. Get Martin up, good, has a chance for three.
Watch it again. Joe Wolf, shot, caroms off the back of the rim. Watch Warren Martin off the North Carolina bench go up. 6'11 and a half, he uses every inch to get that one in.
You can see from that graphic how well he has come on in the late stages of this season. His average up to 14 points a game. And now an 11-3 Auburn lead. Or rather, North Carolina lead. Full court press employed by the Tar Heels. Frank Ford to the basket and good. Boy, he really could elbow his way through there and did so with some degree of grace that time.
He did a great job of using his body. He leaned his body up and beat Martin. Look at Ford, a great shot on the inside.
That's the counter, as you saw, that we are under the 15-minute mark. It's a 13-5 North Carolina lead.
Good action for both clubs. Game's going up and down the floor, both playing well right now. North Carolina obviously having the better of it.
Jeff Moore in the corner. That shot no good. Joe Wolf with a rebound did a good job of boxing Chris Morris out. Here comes Buzz Peterson. Lob pass, Doherty, turnaround, good.
Gotta be a timeout. He's gotta take one. He's getting killed.
One wonder if the experienced North Carolina team might have an advantage early on.
Lead is because they're getting the basketball inside to Doherty. Watch Frank Ford attempt to get this right here, this pass. It goes right by him. Doherty up in the air, his size, big advantage. Just banks it right off the glass, and North Carolina adds two more to their total.
Tar Heels have jumped out to a 15-5 lead with 14:29 to go. Field goal percentage, Auburn only 20% so far, North Carolina 60%.
That's pretty dramatic evidence right there of the reason they've got that lead. Look at the rebounding. North Carolina up 11-4. They're dominating every statistic.
Auburn has only been out-rebounded 5 times in 33 games this year, and they are 1-4 in those games. Chance for the fast break. Kenny Smith splits the difference, gets the basket.
They are absolutely destroying Auburn right now. A great steal, good hands by Kenny Smith. He takes it all the way, and a good pass by Wolf.
This, of course, only the second time in the NCAA tournament for the Auburn team. They were defeated in the first round last year by 1 point by a Richmond team. Long shot. They're 2 out of 11, and Chuck Person does get the rebound.
About the only thing they're getting are long rebounds.
17-5 with 13:40 to go first half. Here's Smith again. How's that move?
It's a clinic right now by the Tar Heels.
I think he learned that in Queens.
Kenny Smith with two consecutive steals. He's got great hands.
A 14-point lead.
You know, there are those who will argue with you that Kenny Smith may be the best point guard in the entire nation. I'd have a hard time arguing with him to this point.
Where do you think Larry Smith has improved this year over his freshman season?
I think his experience, just maturity, that one extra year in there. Plus the fact, you know, Jordan and Perkins are gone now. He has to pick up some of that slack, and he has to be responsible.
Freshman from hometown boy, Chapel Hill, North Carolina, will replace Kenny Smith.
North Carolina goes to the zone defense, and they packed it back in. Now they come out and try to trap. There's so many different looks on defense. Everything is a little bit different. That's just simply good teaching. It's fundamental teaching.
Well, do you have a sense of Auburn's frustration yet?
Oh, absolutely. There's no question about that. And I think Sonny Smith right now is mulling over in his mind, what can I do to get this thing turned around? They're down 19-5, 14 points, and we haven't even played 8 minutes in the first half.
Back in the shifting zone for North Carolina, Gerald White comes out, looks it over again. 12-22 to go in the first half. 14-point Tar Heel lead. And long shots aren't falling. They can't get it inside because of that height advantage. They are, as you said, getting the occasional long rebound.
Well, you look at Wolf and Martin and Hardy in there. When they spread out, got their arms extended, they almost cover up everything from baseline to baseline. Auburn really finding it difficult to get inside. There's one.
It took them about a minute and a half, but they were patient enough to get the basket from Chuck Person. And it's 19-7 with 11:43 to go first half.
If they're going to get back to this basketball game, they need turnovers from this North Carolina club, and they're very stingy about giving that basketball up. Look out.
Chris Morris for Auburn. Here's Gerald White. From the corner, Frank Ford. And they have to go back and try and set it up again.
All right, they got a turnover. We talked about something they needed. They got it. If they're going to be patient on offense right now, set up and get their good shot, maybe they can work their way back into this game. You can't get it all back at once.
Go inside again. The rebound this time taken down by senior Buzz Peterson. Number 22. Playing, as we said, starting for Steve Hale today. Hale went out of the first round game against Middle Tennessee State. Shoulder separation.
Auburn really packing that zone defense back inside.
Left-handed shot of Brantino Smith won't go. Rebound. Here's Gerald White. Two on two. Traveling. Seven North Carolina edge in rebound. Check the lineup for North Carolina now as Kenny Smith is back in the lineup along with Brad Doherty, Joe Wolf, Warren Martin, who was fouled underneath by number 14, Johnny Lynn, who just come in for Auburn. Here's the field goal percentage, Larry, 62-20.
Well, that just tells the story right
back at the line, shooting two.
Vern, I'll tell you something else Dean Smith has done. He's really put a lot of pressure on the Auburn offense. He's packed that zone back in so tightly. He knows they're not shooting well from the outside, and he's put that additional pressure on them to convert those long shots. It really becomes more difficult for the Auburn Tigers.
14-point lead at the 10.5-minute mark. Another substitution now for North Carolina as Curtis Hunter, number 43, has joined the lineup. So North Carolina has Hunter, Ranzino Smith, Kenny Smith, Warren Martin, and Brad Doherty in white right now. Johnny Lynn, another freshman guard, number 14, is in the lineup for Auburn, along with Frank Ford, Chuck Person. Ball rejected by Warren Martin. He's really played well in this 5 minute spurt in which he's been in the game. Bob pass, 72. No goaltending call.
Great block.
From the corner, Curtis Hunter. Not there, rebound, Auburn, Chuck Person. Frank Ford will shoot a couple.
Get easy baskets because they can't go up against their defense, but North Carolina is packed back in the paint.
Frank Ford had a perfect 9-for-9 game against Kansas last week. 23 points in that victory. gets one of two here.
Getting the ball inside against the North Carolina zone defense. This was the only time so far in the first half they've been able to do it, and they got it to their star, Chuck Person. He received it in the paint, turned, went straight up with the basketball. Furness, the only time they've gotten in there and gotten against that North Carolina zone.
Well, they are now 3 of 16 shooting from the field in the first half. And North Carolina has outscored Auburn 17-5 in the last 8 minutes and 2 seconds. Thus, the reason for the 21-8 lead. Bert Lundquist and Larry Conley with you from the Birmingham Jefferson Civic Center on CBS Sports in the Southeast Regional Semifinal. That's pretty much the way it's gone for North Carolina here in the first half.
The height has just destroyed Auburn. They can't get up with those big, tall guys inside.
23-8, 9:20 to play. Johnny Lynn from Hendersonville, Tennessee, number 14. And they'll try and work it inside to Person. A nice move by Chuck Person.
But if they're able to get it to him in that position, he can turn and go on Martin. Martin is not a great leaper. He doesn't jump very high, but he's so big. Person is a great leaper. He can take it and go straight up at the basket. Where they've got position Martin right there, they can get him the ball, he'll score.
They're just going to try it over and over and over and over.
What did Sonny Smith tell us yesterday? He says, I'm scared to death of the lob.
Sonny Smith said, if we play a basketball above the rim, we've got no chance. And that is exactly what Dean Smith has in mind. Warren Martin with 10 points. Nice counter move by Frank Ford, rather.
How about that? You're 6'4", and you shoot it over 7 feet.
25-12, 8:25 to go in the first half. Denny Smith has 7. Back to Rancino Smith. Curtis Hunter. Brad Doherty, nice bounce pass out to Rancino Smith. Curtis Hunter with a rebound. He'll shoot a couple. Just a sophomore who's been bothered by injuries during his career. Had to miss few games in the middle of this season. Curtis Hunter at the line.
That's about the only thing in the first half that North Carolina has not done well.
And even at that, 6 of 8. Gerald White, 12 to Frank Ford. Around the horn, left side to Chris Morris. Back to Person.
Look at Doherty out on Person out front. That's a long way for a 6'11 guy to come out and guard. Not a bad idea. With Doherty's reach, he really gives Person a tough obstacle to shoot over. And Dean Smith has a lot of confidence in that young man to bring him that far out. He's very agile. North Carolina now straight man-to-man.
With a rebound after a fine move with his left elbow.
Doherty got away with one right there.
This time, the alley-oop for the lob. Back on February the 8th, and has been under increasing pressure from alumni and some of the athletic staff to rescind that decision. But all indications are from him that he fully intends to go through with it. Nice. But look at the altered shot that was forced on 24. For the Auburn Tigers as Doherty draws the foul.
Watch it again. It's a great move. It looked like Kerry Holland on the inside gets the rebound. You see Ford receive the pass in heavy traffic. He got it up over Doherty right there. Watch him go back after Kerry Holland with a good strong rebound. He goes to the other side. Doherty goes to the floor, but he's going to get the foul.
Gary Holland, a senior from Baldwin, Florida. Warren Martin, number 54. Person with a rebound. The 25-14 game with 6:57 to go in the first half.
All of a sudden, you get a little bit of a feeling that things may be going back Auburn's way.
Funny, I was just going to ask you about that because I had that same intuitive sense myself.
Well, if they get a basket here, what they'll do is bring this crowd back into the game because that'll be the closest they've gotten since the early part of the first half. He's got
the corner, too strong. Nice rebound.
There was nobody on the other side for North Carolina.
And it is under a double-digit game now, back to 25-16. And Larry, listen to this Auburn crowd.
Carolina doing a great job of moving the basketball. Auburn really packing that zone in. Oh, Kenny Smith almost lost.
6:05 to go in the first half. 25-16. Joe Wolf, Kenny Smith.
Good patience by the Tar Heels right now. They want it inside.
Daugherty to Warren Martin. That's 12 for Warren Martin off the bench in the first half.
The Auburn staff is off the bench complaining about 3 seconds. They think Daugherty and Martin are parking in there, and they want them out.
Turnaround jumper off the rim. Person with a rebound. Auburn is getting a few offensive rebounds there.
Yeah, they're getting a few lucky bounces, and things are coming out away from it. The last trip down the floor, they got one with nobody around for North Carolina.
Turnaround. Holland draws the foul from Buzz Peterson, number 22, but he'll not get the chance to
reduce that deficit that they've got.
Kerry Holland is one of the few men you will see playing from off the bench. Auburn is not that deep. Usually they'll rely on 7 or 8. That's about it. Harlan gets them both. It's a 27-18 game at the 5:18 mark of the first half. Full court press after the free throw employed by the Tigers. And Daugherty almost shot it.
Wolf and Daugherty both down there at 6'10 and 6'11, down there handling the press. Good idea. Put the basketball above your head. They can't reach it.
Warren Martin in the corner. Looks inside for Daugherty, goes back around the corner. Kenny Smith, there it is again. Oh, nice block, and then the bounce goes Joe Wolf's way.
They're just playing volleyball up there. The ball stays up there, and you see nothing but guys in white jerseys just playing with it.
All right, our research hasn't gone that deep, but I can't imagine that Auburn is taking color team this year. Foul underneath.
And again, it's Kerry Holland back in there in the midst of all that tall timber. He's only 6'7", 230 pounds. He takes up a lot of room, but he's getting inside against that North Carolina zone defense and causing them some problems.
Joe Wolf's second personal foul. Substitutions for both teams now. Darren Guest, number 32, has come in, replacing Frank Ford for Auburn. Francino Smith is back in the lineup, number 33 for North Carolina, along with Dave Hobson. And Brad Daugherty, Kenny Smith stay in with Joe Wolf.
That's an interesting move right there by Auburn and Sonny Smith. What he's done is put in a guy 6'9 and taking out a guy who's 6'4. Probably feels like he needs some more size inside, and I would agree.
Holland gets 1 of 2. It's a double-digit lead for North Carolina. It had been 14, however, and it's now down.
Never more evident than in this series right here. Watch the basketball come inside. It's a lob. You'll see Kenny Smith on the outside. He gets it back outside. Watch the pass go to Martin on the lob. He'll miss it right there. That's one attempt. Watch Martin get it back. 2. Go back a third time right there. 24, Joe Wolf right there, who was circled, is the man who ends up getting it in.
Those are the moments when you're at the shorter team. You plead for an explanation of genetic differences. How did it happen this way? Auburn, in addition, is hitting only 7 of 24 for 29%, and North Carolina 12 of 22, 55%. 4:10 to go, first half. Granzino Smith and Kenny Smith at the guards.
North Carolina again showing good patience against this Auburn zone. They've built themselves a 10-point lead. They're not going to squander it.
With Daugherty inside, Kenny Smith. Now they'll go probe what's over on the right side. Sonny Smith up, yelling at his guys' defensive effort. Wolf.
Auburn with a chance now to cut it to 8. North Carolina comes out of that zone defense. They've gone straight up man-to-man.
Gerald White. Darren Guest quickly over to Chris Morris with the 34. Well, we hear a lot of talk about Dean Smith going with his tall starting lineup. This is about as tall a lineup as Sonny Smith can counter with, and Chuck Person gets the shot.
That's the best he can do as far as putting him on the floor. Now, all of a sudden, it's down to 8.
And once again, the Auburn crowd is on his feet.
North Carolina's passed up a lot of good shots. Kenny Smith had a couple, so did Renzino Smith. They need to go ahead and take those. There's one.
Yep. He It's almost as if they're concentrating too much on trying to get it up above the rim, don't you think?
Well, and the thing about it is, when you get a tall team like that, you really concentrate on trying to get the ball to them. And really, Ranzino Smith and Kenny Smith are good shooting guards. Here's a double team out front. Kenny Smith will do that. He'll leave his man and go double team away from the ball.
Chuck Person, averaging 22 points per game this year. He's now got 8 in the first half. It's back to an 8-point deficit.
And Bert, he can get him from anywhere. He'll get him from 20, 25 feet. He'll get him from 2 feet. He'll do it on the break. He's a complete basketball player, an outstanding athlete.
Two-time All-SEC performance and runner-up a year ago to Charles Barkley as Player of the Year in the SEC.
There you go. You got to let those guards take those shots. You can't let them back away from that. Now, what that does for you is when you come out to pick them up, it loosens up the inside. Now they can go back inside because Auburn's going to start to concentrate on the guards.
33-23, 150 to go in the first half.
What makes it nice is you recruit players that can do that. Then you can do, you can run any offense.
Traveling. All right, students. All chosen academic fields. 33-23, 135. Remaining in the half. Tip, and it'll be no.
Peterson's in the game now, and Zeno Smith is out. There it goes inside.
Foul underneath. We're only a minute 25 away from halftime, and coming up at halftime, we go back to our
scores. It really directs traffic out there, because he's the guy that they look to.
It's amazing to me that even though he is a junior in his third year, he is still only a 19-year-old teenager. Second youngest player on the North Carolina squad. Brad Doherty. Kind of reached a low point at midseason this year in a loss at Clemson when he had the 5 points and was roundly criticized by the media in North Carolina, but has come on lately, though he missed those two free throws, and now here's Auburn with a chance to get it back into a single-digit number as far as deficit.
North Carolina's going to go back to their man-to-man defense. There's Chris Morris.
Oh, nice move. Warren Martin there is to clear the boards for North Carolina. We're at the 1 minute mark in the first half. 33-23.
It looks as if North Carolina is going to hold the basketball for the last shot of the first half. We've got 50 seconds left to play.
Winner of this game will meet Villanova here in Birmingham on Sunday afternoon for the right to go to the Final Four in Lexington.
For all those fans who are North Carolina fans, so they'll all remember that famous four-pointer offense that Dean Smith used to run before they had the shot clock. I think they may get a chance to see it in this basketball game. They're running some version of it right now.
Back to 20 seconds. And they obviously are going to work for just the final shot. Desperation shot by Auburn. And it'll be a 10-point lead at halftime. The score at halftime is North Carolina 33, Auburn 23. Coming up at halftime, we'll inbound for the North Carolina Tar Heels, and we'll check the lineup now. Kenny Smith at the point guard, number 30, along with Joe Wolf, Brad Doherty, Dave Popson, and Buzz Peterson. Same quintet that started the game. And for Dean Smith's North Carolina Tar Heels, that's the bunch that jumped out to a 19-5 lead. Rebound tipped in twice, or tipped twice, and finally Jeff Moore controls for Auburn. So they do get the board. Long shot, won't fall to Gerald White. Doherty in the rebound. Tipped away, out of bounds. It'll be North Carolina. For the Auburn Tigers, they've got Chris Morris, Jeff Moore, Chuck Person, Gerald White back in the lineup. And Frank Ford also, who is a very quiet figure in the first half, number 15.
North Carolina really does a great job of moving the basketball in the perimeter of a zone. They'll have three or four opportunities and shots, just like Kenny Smith had right there. But they'll pass it up to give the ball to another teammate who may have a little bit better shot, like Joe Wolf. He didn't take one. He gets it back to Smith. Patience, and it really builds good confidence among your team members when you move the basketball like that.
Wolf again passes on the shot. Try the right side. Buzz Peterson.
What another thing, too, you can watch about them. It's almost automatic with them. There's Peterson with a shot. They almost always give you a ball call. They always show you ball every time that it starts to go up.
Frank Ford tries to take it down low, decides to come back outside. 23-23. That makes it an 8-point lead again. The largest lead in the game was 15 at 23-8. North Carolina on top, and also a 25-10. And it's now back to an 8-point margin. And there's a turnover. Steal by the Auburn Tigers. Chris Morris up and in. The lead has been whittled to 6.
Listen to this crowd.
Now listen how quiet they get.
Now the North Carolina crowd comes on.
Back to an 8-point margin, 17-45 to go in the game. Winner goes on to meet Villanova. Only the second NCAA appearance for the Auburn Tigers. Sonny Smith in what might be his last game as the Auburn coach. Rebound, Popson. Buzz Peterson.
They got 4-on-2. They got the numbers. You know, I find it interesting, Vern, that ever since Hale went out of the lineup, Kenny Smith has really picked up his game. I mean, he's had a great year all year. But when Steve Hale went out of the basketball game with a separated shoulder earlier in the tournament, he really has assumed the leadership and really taken over running this club. And I think that's a positive force right now for Carolina.
Where do they still miss Steve Hale the most?
Well, obviously, they're missing his 10-point average, but also he's a very well-rounded player. Says, oh, what a great shot by Ford. But they miss a lot of things about Steve Hale. You see him right there. He's got that coat slung over that shoulder that he's operated on. He's a fine young man. He's a pre-med student, in fact.
Junior from Jenks, Oklahoma, will be back next year. 37-29, 16-40 remaining in the ballgame. Buzz Peterson.
It's very seldom you see North Carolina take a bad shot. They just don't take it unless it's a panicky situation.
Nothing wrong with that. That's Popson with 4 points. It's a 39-29 game, 16-15 to go in the ballgame.
Now North Carolina goes into a man-to-man defense, and they pull Kenny Smith out on Dwight. There's the double team. You saw Popson come from the lead. Good move by Person. How about that for a baseline move?
12 points for Chuck Person. Back to an 8-point margin. Just under 16 minutes to go in the game. North Carolina jumped off to a 19-5 lead. Traveling.
Point game, it could be 6.
Smallest margin since the opening run has been 6. That was a few moments ago. Morris, left side to Frank Ford, guarded by Joe Wolf for the moment. Over to Gerald White. Now they put Chris Morris out on the top of the key.
How about that? 6'8 running your offense up front.
Whoops. Person controls, but he's almost trapped. 15-18 remaining in the ballgame. 39-31.
Was Kenny Smith quick, huh?
Gee, Christmas.
Showing good patience against this North Carolina zone right now. Got it to the man.
Short, rebound, Jeff Ford, turn around, no good. And 6'10½, Joe Wolf clears the board for the Tar Heels. Peterson, not there. Over the back, reaching foul on Joe Wolf. Has indicated his intention to resign when the season is over. 14-40 remaining in the game. Gerald White back at the point guard position now. Has Ford on right wing, Chris Morris on the left. There's Morris who will pass and shot.
You know, Brian, with all that activity they've had in the second half, they've really only cut the deficit by 2 points. They were down by 10. They're down by 8 right now.
6. Chuck Person has 14 points. He is the only man in double figures for the Auburn Tigers. And we have Warren Martin back in the lineup now for North Carolina. He had 12 first half points. Tries to work loose underneath. Ian Doherty prowling underneath that glass. Meanwhile, Kenny Smith hits from 16 feet.
He can beat you every way. He can shoot the jump shot. He can handle the ball on the break. He's a great defensive player. He's just an outstanding athlete. Nice to have him around for a couple of years, I'll tell you. Dean Smith's going to be pleased to have him.
Auburn, keep in mind, started the game with a 3 of 16 effort from the field. They have improved considerably in this half. 9. 13:38 to go. It's an 8-point margin.
Show a little bit more patience on offense against that North Carolina zone. They're trying to get a little bit better shot, and I think they've gotten it, only because they have shown better patience.
Ocean, Chris Morris, Frank Ford.
Moving the ball in the perimeter. I can guarantee you they're looking for Person. They're trying to find an opening for him. He's got Daugherty on the other side over there, and he's trying to post him up, and as soon as he does, Peterson goes back and helps.
And the shot is missed. Here comes Kenny Smith. Could be a 10-point margin again. Peterson in the corner. Not there. Good rebound cleared by Chuck Person. Bounce pass. Ford. No. Rebound Gerald White off balance. Shot goes.
Watch out. Here goes North Carolina. Kenny Smith. Got it. Don't ever close your eyes because you'll miss something if he's in the game.
He's got 15 points now. It's a 43-35 ball game. The moment Auburn seems on the verge of really turning it around, goes the other way.
It always seems to be Kenny Smith right in the midst of it, too.
Carolina in that zone. Person. Tired of the harassment on that right side, comes over here, and Jeff Moore hits.
That was good ball movement that time. They really moved it well on the perimeter, and Moore floated into the middle of that zone, and they got him the basketball. Sometimes you concentrate so much on one player, you forget the other guys.
Less than 12 minutes to go, a 6-point difference again. Buzz Peterson. Oh, what a pass. Goaltending.
What did I say? He'll beat you with a press. He'll beat you handling the basketball. He'll beat you shooting, handling. He can also beat you with a great pass, and you're going to see it right here. Look at that. Don't telegraph it. Just send it to me.
.45-37, 11:38 to go. It was in this round a year ago that Indiana knocked off a highly favored North Carolina team and cost them a shot at the championship.
Sonny Smith over on the bench right there pushing his offense back out, told his player to take it back out. He says, set up a regular. Let's see what a regular is. Almost a regular bounce off the knee right there.
Chuck Person. Underneath. Brad Daugherty is howling about a traveling call.
Look at Dean Smith jumping up and down over here. He's on the sidelines trying to indicate that Holland got the basketball, went straight up and came back down with it. Let's see if he did. There's Holland with it. He starts up, comes back down. He did come down with the basketball.
Well, despite that, Holland will shoot too. And Dean Smith is imitating what he saw on the court. Gary Holland off the bench has 6 points in the ballgame. Daugherty with the rebound. 45-38, 11:03 to go in the game. Winner meets Villanova on Sunday afternoon. Ball the right to go to the final four.
Auburn continues to pack its own defense back inside. There's Wolf.
Joe Wolf has 4 points. And it's a 9-point North Carolina lead. Ramzino Smith is back in the ballgame now, number 33, freshman guard, along with Kenny Smith, number 30, Warren Martin, Joe Wolf, and Brad Daugherty. Talk about how young this Auburn team is. It's a very young North Carolina bunch as well.
Oh, it really is. You take Daugherty, a junior, Martin, a junior, Wolf, a sophomore, Smith, a sophomore, Popson, a sophomore. Just outstanding talent coming back. They've had a great recruiting year, too.
Johnny Lynn, number 14, has come into lineup for Auburn. Person rejected by Martin. Shot by Morris is too strong. Ramzino Smith, number 33. What a pass. Shot short. Person wisely pulls up because North Carolina had drifted back in good defensive position.
Well, that could have put him up by 11, Vernon. Really made it difficult on Auburn. Daugherty missed an easy layup. That's a great pass by Ranzino Smith, getting the basketball as he broke to the basket.
Person. There's two. Frank Ford, number 15. It's a seven-point game at 47-40.
Look at Wolf running the offense. There he is, 6'10 out front. Now they move Ranzino Smith over. He gets it to Wolf, and there's Martin open. Chose not to get him the ball.
This shot not there. We'll hear a howl now because Brad Daugherty and Frank Ford were having at each other under the basket.
You don't think this isn't a battle? Watch these two guys go at it. Ford, 6'4 and a half, about 210. He just sloughs off Daugherty right here. Watch him get this rebound. Leave me alone like a fly on my arm.
47-40. We've got 9:17 to go. Timeout has been called.
Sam, and I think North Carolina may be getting a little lackadaisical. Daugherty missing that layup just a few seconds ago. I think that may be indicative of them maybe losing their concentration a little bit.
See, the rebounding edge now belongs to Auburn, the shorter team. They lead in total rebounds 28-27, having trailed at one point 21-14.
Here's a strange strategy. Auburn's behind, and yet they're trying to get North Carolina to come out of the zone.
Gerald White. And Sonny Smith says that's the spot. This is as close as it has been since the first 3 minutes of the game. 47-42. Smith with a skip cast pass clear across court to Ranzino Smith.
North Carolina doing a good thing here. They're showing patience against this Auburn defense. They'll try to work it inside if they can. Get a good, easy shot.
Ranzino Smith with 2 points. First time he has scored since the LSU game. Let's see if he can get two. Nope, not there. Now this time they're going to call it on Chuck Person.
Nodding his head in agreement. I think he was right. Chuck Person did commit his second personal foul. He and Joe Wolf are really going at it. Get a little rough out there, Bird.
That's the first team foul on Auburn. And Wolf and Person shove elbows at each other on the inbounds play. Now Wolf. Pass on the shot. 47-42, just under 8 minutes to go. Ranzino Smith. Hit Wolf.
Play by Wolf. He really got up in the air. I'm wondering if that little battle he had with Person did to get him a little extra adrenaline to get up there.
They do look a little lethargic. North Carolina, that is.
Auburn again moving the basketball well against the North Carolina zone defense. They're really trying to get it around the perimeter. But they'll look inside. Holland and Person have had some success against this Tar Heel zone.
Gerald White from Augusta, Georgia. Chris Morris. Five rebounds. Chuck Person. The tip. Finally it's in. Gary Holland. Back to five with 6:50 to go in the game. Look for all the world like Wayman Tisdale shot the other night. The one that hung on the rim for 3 seconds and beat out Louisiana Tech. Wolf to Smith. To Ranzino Smith.
You see him give that little ball fake. They'll take it, get you up in the air, and there's the shot.
Warren Martin underneath. Offensive foul, I think. Yes. And a chance for Auburn to shave the 6:22 remaining. 49-44.
First half, I think everyone in this building anticipated to be in North Carolina. Now all of a sudden, who knows?
The Tar Heels jumped out to a 19-5 lead to open the game. Person. Rebound, Morris. Altered shot, falls! He had to put a huge arch on it.
But they're getting everything off of that glass. North Carolina has just lost the edge in their rebounding, and that's what's hurting them.
32 rebounds for Auburn, 29 for North Carolina. This is a North Carolina team that measures 6'10", 6'10", 6'11", along the front line. A three-point edge for the Tar Heels. Clock shows 5:25 and winding down. Seen this before?
It would not surprise me to see North Carolina start thinking about going into that four-quarter offense that they like to run. I'm sure they've worked on it. Right now, the type of lineup they have in there, they've got three big guys who are not very quick. The only two they've got that are quick are Kenny Smith and on the other side, Buzz Peterson. And it really runs better when you've got three or four quick guys in there. Now Auburn goes man-to-man. They go out of that zone. Good feed by Gordy. What a pass to Smith.
Within 10 seconds of going to the man-to-man, Doherty finds Kenny Smith underneath, and Sonny Smith wants to talk it over with him.
You're going to see him right here. Watch Doherty and watch Smith make this backdoor cut. Good heads-up pass by Doherty and a great cut by Kenny Smith. That's just intelligent basketball. Watch him again, isolated right here, Kenny Smith. He sees the opening, there's the cut, and Doherty found him.
That's still the tide, at least momentarily, because it pushed North Carolina back to a five-point edge. As the offensive rebounding of Sonny Smith's Auburn Tiger team has really paid dividends for them in this ballgame.
It really has. Right now, Auburn has 16 offensive rebounds, and North Carolina's 8 in the second half.
Back to three, Chuck Person. 16 points. The last time that North Carolina led by three was at 4-1. Warren Martin had 12 in the first half, has been silent in this second half thus far. Buzz Peterson, man-to-man offense now by the Auburn Tigers, 4-10 to go in the game.
The first time we've seen Auburn play defense like this out there with Chrysler.
Foul on Chuck Person. Person. And we're at the four-minute mark with the score 51-48. Warren Martin guarded by Jeff Moore. Kenny Smith, game high of 17 points for the North Carolina Tar Heels.
White's backing off of Smith right now. He doesn't want to get up close to him. Smith very quick, gets inside quickly, and if he does, he'll dish it off if he finds the opening.
Buzz Peterson.
There's Martin.
Foul on Jeff Moore, number 40. And that is only the third team foul.
The one thing that North Carolina does so well is they post up well with these big guys. Once they get it down low in the block like that, it's really tough to get it away from them. And if you try, you usually end up fouling.
Substitution for the Auburn Tigers now. Jeff Moore will get a rest. And Kerry Holland is back into the lineup. Holland with 6 points in the reserve role so far tonight. 3:38 on the clock. Winner goes up against Villanova Sunday afternoon, as Raleigh Massimino's team defeated Maryland in a very low-scoring and poor shooting game here earlier. Brad Doherty to Kenny Smith. And cat-quick Gerald White comes over to cover.
Great move by White, but Smith had ideas of letting one go, and White got there in front of him before he could even get it out.
3:13 remaining.
Carolina doing a pretty good job of controlling the basketball right now. Auburn, with just slight pressure, not a whole lot. They keep looking to the inside. If they can get it, they'll get it there. And here's Martin.
And Wolf. 53-48.
It's an ideal way to run your delay game. Stick two guys in there who can handle it. Kenny Smith, Buzz Peterson. Then you continually look to the inside. That time Martin got it and found Wolf.
Person will take it for 20. Rebound, Buzz Peterson. He'll immediately slow it down.
Now they start to run it again.
2:25 to go in the ballgame. With a valiant comeback by Auburn, they trailed 19-5 in the first 7 or 8 minutes of the first half. Cut that to 10 at the half. They have shaved it to as few as three. Near takeaway by Chuck Person. That's a turnover. Sonny Smith wants a timeout.
Good idea. He needs to sit down.
The other day said something about he thought the whole Western region ought to be called an all-Italian final. And he particularly appreciated the contribution of Alabama coach Wimp Sanders-Somi.
53-48 at the two-minute mark in this one.
North Carolina away from their zone, but they open up man-to-man. Boy, the poise that goes on between these two coaches.
Not quite there for Chuck Person, and a big rebound now for the Tar Heels. Kenny Smith. 53-48, 1:43 to go. Gerald White takes the foul. That's the fourth team foul.
North Carolina really sitting in the driver's seat right now. They've got an opportunity to run some clock here, and they know they're going to get fouled.
Warren Martin somehow gets out of it. Auburn's ball.
I don't know what Martin was thinking about. I don't know why he didn't give the basketball up when he got double teamed. I guess he felt like he could fight through it, and he just threw it away.
Trailing by five. Here comes Auburn with under 90 seconds remaining.
Oh, what a shot back forward.
Back to three. And another reason for the Auburn comeback has been the lack of turnovers. They have not turned it over at all in this half. Kenny Smith, foul on Gerald White. That's the fourth team foul. Or is it the fifth? Be the fifth. Ranzino Smith coming in at a guard spot now for Dean Smith's North Carolina team.
Pretty good idea. Get another ball handler in there and let somebody take care of it. You've got Peterson left in there, Ranzino Smith, and Kenny Smith, and you can just about bet that those are going to be the three guys that can control the basketball. And look for the safety valves inside. You've got Wolf and Daugherty both in there.
1:08 remaining.
Got a trap.
Kenny Smith.
Got out of it. Got it to Kenny Smith.
Two-shot foul? Nope.
Well, they had to keep fouling to get it to that point where they could walk to the free throw line
exactly.
And shoot it. And that's why they fouled so often. Now they can pick out somebody to foul, send to the line, stop it, and make North Carolina make their free throws.
In the meantime, Dean Smith wants to talk it over. As the Tar Heels take a timeout with 59 seconds to go in the game, and their lead is now at three. With 1 minute remaining in Birmingham, Alabama, Vern Lundquist along with Larry Conley as the Auburn team has fought from behind. They trail by as many as 15. They have one timeout left. The favored North Carolina Tar Heels have three timeouts left. And it has been a spirited Auburn.
If they don't get the steal, then immediately take the foul. Good pressure.
Chuck Person.
Lost a second. One seven. Second.
I got the ball, but he didn't quite. Fourth foul on Chuck Person. Well, you really don't want this North Carolina. You know, it's a darned if you do, darned if you don't dilemma, because they are one of the better free throw shooting teams in the country.
Well, they're shooting 76%, and they just sent a guy to the line who's right at their average. He's shooting 77%.
First free throw for Joe Wolf tonight.
Those were big ones. Got him a 5-point lead.
Chris Morris.
Oh, my goodness. Walked right in his face.
7 points for Morris. Back to three. Backcourt foul on Frank Ford.
So what happens? You end up sending a guy to the line who can shoot 86%.
Well, look at those guys on the floor right now, and there's not you can't go wrong, really. Warren Martin, nearly 7 feet, hit 68%. And he is the least effective. Smith is now 2 of 2 for the night and brings just a bit of a smile to Dean Smith's face.
Not quite yet.
Yep. Frank Ford.
Bernay have made two absolutely impossible shots. to stay within 3 points of this North Carolina.
Here's Smith across the timeline.
Boy, he handles the ball well.
Foul called on Chris Morris. 28 seconds to go.
He really had no problem with that press at all. They set up a 2-2-1 full court zone press. He went right between them.
The young Auburn team.
He has shot three free throws, and none of them have hit the rim. That one did, and missed. Big miss.
Four-point game. Gerald White almost traveled. Foul by Peterson.
Now it's North Carolina's turn to take some fouls. That's their fifth one. They have it.
So Auburn will inbound. Gerald White underneath. Season hitting 66%.
He missed it. They got it.
Traveling.
Burn, the crowd disagrees with the call, but it's go to the floor and your feet come off the floor, it's automatic. You got to travel.
Watch it again, Larry Conley.
Here's Holland's shot. He got the basket. He misses the shot. Watch it come back out. Person gets the rebound, gets thrown to the floor, and when you raise those feet off the floor, it's travel. Oh, man. Kenny Smith's the guy they need to get it to. Good pressure.
Does not get it. North Carolina ball. Chuck Person thought it rolled off one of the Auburn Guardians, or the North Carolina Guardians.
One tick of the clock went down, so they lost it. It's back to 15 seconds. Well, that was great pressure that time by Auburn.
Francino Smith is fouled in the backcourt by Frank Ford. It'll be a 1-1.
Except for the line.
Water. Warren Martin getting ready to come back in for North Carolina. A 4-point lead once more. Substitution, Warren Martin comes in immediately for Ranzino Smith, who gets a few high fives along the bench for hitting two clutch free throws.
Well deserved.
Here's Kenny Smith, Showtime. His final game. He has announced his intention to resign when the season is over. For his very young Auburn Tiger squad, a marvelous run to the NCAA championship comes to an end at the hands of the experienced North Carolina team. Now let's go to Dick Stockton.